Hello everyone, good morning all of you. Welcome to all of you in my today's online lecture. Today we are going to study some of the new topics regarding chapter number 1, where to look from, and that topic is pattern. And then with the help of this pattern, we have to do one activity. Do you know what is pattern? How you can draw these patterns, where you are looking this pattern, and how can you form these all patterns? See all the answers of our question. An arrangement that follows a certain order is known as patterns. If you look around you, everywhere you can see some of the design on the floor, some design on the furniture, some objects in that, some designs are there. These all designs, if they follow a certain order, like if they repeated that design, if they repeated that shape, then that arrangement is known as patterns. Patterns are in a number as well as in the shapes also. But in this chapter, we have to just only study it only and only about the shapes, patterns in a shapes only. In a shapes, patterns made by a straight line and also by the curve line. If you see many objects around you, in that some patterns are there. It is not necessary that all patterns made by a straight line only or by curved line only. Now what is the meaning of curved line? It's like a circle. It's like somewhat circular surface. So it is not necessary that the patterns are always made by a straight line. Sometimes it is made by straight line and sometimes it is made by curved line, as well as in some of the patterns you can see that both lines are there. In general, patterns are known as a symmetrical figures. Now you already studied what is the symmetrical figures. If you divide any of the figure into two equal parts, then that figure is known as symmetrical figures. Same thing happens in a patterns. If you divide that pattern into two equal parts, if that patterns are repeated simultaneously, then that is known as symmetrical figure. Many times patterns like a mirror house. Now what is the work of mirror house? Mirror house can divide. Mirror house can be seen the image of the half portion. So many times pattern work as a mirror house. Now you see here some of the patterns made by a straight line. This is known as a dot grid. In dot grid, now what is the meaning of dot grid? If you look here, some dots are there, and that all dots are equidistant from each other. So with the help of these dot grid, you have to make some straight line patterns. You have to make some patterns in that you can use the straight line. This thing you can do in the time of the Diwali, when you are making rangoli of different shapes. At that time you are using this. So first pattern of the straight line, that is the rangoli. This is the simple rangoli which you can use, which we can draw with the help of some dot grids. Second one is the letter box. It's the one type of letter. And the third one, that is also a straight line patterns. These all are the examples of straight line patterns. Now let us see some of the pattern which is made by curved line. These patterns also we have to draw in a dot grid. See, This is the first pattern, which is made by curve line. Curve lines, it looks somewhat like a circular surface. It's somewhat like circle. Then this is the second pattern. Third, you can see in this, here they were given first horizontal and then vertical, horizontal, vertical. These all shapes are repeated. One time horizontal and second time it's a vertical. Then again, these all are the circle which is joined all together. This is also known as curve line patterns. And this is also curve line pattern. Now let us study how to complete shapes. You have to complete the shapes by using this dot grid only. But before completing any of the shape, you have to remember one rule to complete any of the shape, and that rule is that, let us see, whatever the amount, whatever the size of that arrow, of that shape, of that line, you have to just move that much only when you have to complete any of the shape. Let us see here. In this one slanting line is there, so on another side we have to draw that much slanting line only. Then after, they were given standing slipping line to you of 1 centimeter, so you have to draw only of that 1 centimeter. Then after, again of the slanting line, so we have to draw again 1 slanting line. Then again 1 slanting line. So you have to draw that much of slanting line, then slipping line, so you have to draw slipping line, and then you have to complete the shape. So the shape looks like a star. So your figure looks like this. Now your second one, here with the help of the standing line and slipping line, you have to complete this shape. So they were drawing here your standing line of 1.5 centimeter. So you have to draw standing line and then you have to draw slipping line. So your figure is complete. Now again here it is a 1 centimeter of slipping line. So you have to draw another 1 centimeter of slipping line and then you have to draw standing line. So your figure is complete. Then after, here in this shape, they were given standing line also and circular lines also. So you have to draw that much size of circular size and that much of standing line and complete this shape. Again, here they were given standing line, slipping line and slanting line. So with the help of these all three lines size, we have to complete the shapes also. So it looks like this. Then after, only they were given this line, so you have to complete this shape. So it looks like this. Then here also they were given three lines to you and you have to complete that shape. Then again you have to complete this shape like this. Now let us do one activity. In this activity you have to make one mask. So first, what you have to do, take a piece of a blank paper like this. Then after, fold it along the middle. You take this blank paper and you have to fold that blank paper from the middle side, from the middle. So it look like this. Then after, on one side, draw the figure. If you want to make the mask of animal, then just draw half portion of that shape, half of that figure, and then cut it out using the pair of the scissors. What you have to do? You have to just cut this extra blank paper. When you cut this blank paper with the help of the scissor, then your half portion look like this. Then after, open that fold and make the eyes and nose, etc. So when you open that fold which you already cut, it looked like this, and then after you just drew their eyes and nose. Then after just color it and tie a rubber band on its back. Your mark is ready. Thank you all of you. I hope you all like my work and also you study very well. Thank you.